How y'all doing, my YouTube family and friends? My diehard, real diehard fans for R. Kelly, how are you? I just wanted to play this one here today to bring you this message about the backstabbers. I seen a lot of backstabbing and, you know, everybody's throwing everybody under the bus type of move going on lately. You know, the season coming to a close. And I guess everybody want a clean house. You know how that is, right? Everybody trying to get their house in order, right? And I know I'm cleaned house. I just know I cleaned house because I know this is going to be my video for the finale of the R. Kelly saga and all that's been going on with the R. Kelly. Not that I'm going to be giving up on R. Kelly. No, that ain't going to happen. You know, I'm still in support of R. Kelly rights and fighting for his justice. I just wanted to just say that he's going to be all right. You know, those of us that are true supporters, we're going to stay in the background and we're going to continue to pray for R. Kelly and support him in any way that we can, giving our truth with our true hearts, you know, because I've seen now that this has become more of a way for people to, like, make a fortune off of his misfortune. It's all about likes, views, and subscribes. See, my channel has never been about likes, views, and subscribes. I just wanted to just be somebody that wanted to, you know, support R. Kelly. That's all. I just wanted to support him and speak what I feel about what's taking place right now with his constitutional rights being violated and how he's been wronged by the justice system. So it has never been about likes, views, whatever. You never heard me say, please subscribe to my channel, hit the like button, like and share. That has never been my thing. You know, my thing has always been about just saying how I feel about what's taking place with R. Kelly and also keeping everybody encouraged. Those who are in support of him and truly are in support of R. Kelly, that just offering my words of strength and encouragement, not to really harm anyone. And when I was talking about cleaning house, I'm saying I'd like to apologize, openly apologize to those I've offended and those that I have came for when I felt they were going after people that probably didn't deserve to be, you know, attacked at the moment. And I took their back. You know, I looked out for you. But I did that out of the goodness of my heart because I don't like to see nobody being bullied or nobody being falsely accused or attacked or anything on social media. And that's the way I feel. But still in all, I wanted to extend an apology. And I'm going to call their names to Dr. Rice, Sharon Winbush, also to my girl, Sugar and Spice. Let me see who else. I don't want to forget anybody. Hollywood Next. Oh, this one is hard. Kevin Terrell. But I didn't mean to say it like that, y'all. But a lot of times when people come and say things they've been offended by or they've been trying to, you know, pull your coat about or put out there in the, just to put out in the universe about certain things, you know, beware, beware, beware of the sheep's and wolves, the wolves and sheep clothing type of mood, you know. And I know I have took offense to a lot of things that was said, but now I'm starting to see what they see, you know. And I truly apologize for my misunderstanding for these people. But that doesn't mean that I will be rocking with you just because I'm apologizing. You know, I'm just going to stay cool. You know, I'm just going to keep my distance from a lot of things, you know, from a lot of people, because I just see there's a whole lot of back and forth. And, you know, everybody ain't loyal, true to their game or true to what they about. You know, I'm just going to sit back and just watch things a little bit more better now that I got a better understanding of things. And God has brought me to that understanding, opened my eyes to new things. So the year is coming to a close, and this is going to be my finale of my videos for R. Kelly until hopefully God, if I live to see next year, because I'm getting into my holiday right now, and I ain't going to really have time to really, you know, shoot any videos or be all into, I mean, not that I'm not going to be thinking about R. Kelly. I might shoot one just for the holidays, for a Christmas tree and a song that R. Kelly might have done or something, just to celebrate his life and his legacy. Being that this man has made a great contribution to music for 30 years, and I can't forget him during this time of the year. He's truly deeply in my prayers. If anything, I could send a care package or something and you know, help out for him for the holidays, which I know he probably getting a lot of things from a lot of people right now. But my wish for the holiday for him is that he will at least get the opportunity to come out on bond and spend his holidays with his loved ones. Those who love him and care about him, really love him and care about him. Not people that are just looking for a bag, you know? You know, it's heartbreaking. It's really heartbreaking that because of his fame and fortune, that's only why people want to be next to him. Other than that, if they knew him as a person, a personal person, they probably wouldn't have anything to do with him. And that's the sad part about it. And that's what I'm really starting to see now. And it's sad, you know, it happens in this world, but you gotta be careful who you love, who you trust with your heart, who you give your heart to, those people you believe in. Some of them are not as loyal as you think they are. And I love this song. Money will drive some people out of their mind. For the love of money. Have it. Really need it. Yes, me and my husband was pulling out all the oldies, and somehow or the other, I was like, oh, my OJs. And I just thought this one would go really good for this conversation I'm having with you in this video about money, greed, you know, backstabbers. You know, how people gonna do you wrong just because they want something of yours, or they want to take your man or your woman. And it just happens like that. You know, the world is wicked. You know, we got some wicked folks in the world, but you gotta guard your heart and guard your mind and your soul. That's why I tell people like this. I don't rock with nobody at this point. Right now, I just rock alone. I rock with Jesus, and that's it. You know, trying to discern good from evil and what people are out here doing to one another. And I saw a lot on these YouTube streets. Boy, did I see some things. I just saw some people just dogging each other, just throwing each other under the bus. And I have my own personal views, too, about some people that have been on these YouTube streets and people that I have been, you know, actually following. But now I ain't following nobody. I'm about to unsubscribe from everybody. How about that? Even the ones that don't deserve me to unsubscribe for, because I got to start all over again. Yes, that's what I'm going to do for the holidays. Go through my list of people that I want to keep in my life on social media, on YouTube, and everything else that I'm a part of on the account. And I'm just going to go through that list, and I'm going to figure out who's good and who's good to keep around and who's not. But I got to still be careful, because I don't want to move something that might be the cornerstone, you know? The cornerstone. So I got to really pray about it and really start, you know, looking at things real, like a camel going through an eye of a needle. Like, who's been doing what and who's been doing what, you know? So... And some things I did enjoy. You know, a lot of y'all, I did enjoy you. Those who are bloggers, I did enjoy some of the conversations, the good times that we just shared. That's when we all became like in the same like mind. But now I'm feeling kind of some kind of way with some of the things that's starting to, you know, take place right now. But I'm just going to happily sit back and watch all of that. Because I'm just feeling some type of way right now. And you know, with all the backstabbing, people being two-faced and all of that. But anyway, I gotta go. Until then, you all have a blessed and wonderful holiday. Your girl, Casey McDaniel, I'm signing out. Peace.